This world you have made is a beautiful place. It tells the power of your love. We rejoice in the beauty of your world, from the seas to the heavens above. The morning whispers of purity, the evening of your peace. The thunder booms your exuberance in the awesome power you release. This world you have made is a beautiful place. It tells the power of your love. We rejoice in the of your world, from the seas to the heavens above.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: wedding anniversary blessings for Loretta and Linus Gomes, Charlotte and Al Rego, Regina and Darren Pereira, Mirella and Avian Mesquita, birthday blessings for Keegan Hanif, Rickson Lewis, Emilia Asma, Peptina Beth-Gerry, Peter Lobo, good health of Glory Pereira and family, for the newly married couple, for the newborn child and parents, for the well-being of all family members of the Rego, D'Souza, Pinto and Fernandez families, for the departed souls of the Regos and Coutinos, for the souls of Eric Timothy D'Souza, first death anniversary, Catherine Esperance, Cyril D'Souza, Mary DiCuna, Annie Fernandez, Peter and Bella D'Souza, Rufina De Silva, and Virginia Dice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Gather around the altar of the Lord. Let us praise Him and thank Him for His blessings, and seek pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Constantly shape our minds, we pray, O Lord, by the practice of good works, that trying always for what is better, we may strive to hold ever fast the Paschal mystery, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After spending some time in Antioch, Paul departed and went from one place to the next through the region of Galatia and Phrygia, strengthening all the disciples. Now a Jew named Apollos, a native of Alexandria, came to Ephesus. He was an eloquent man, competent in the scriptures. He had been instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in spirit, he spoke and taught accurately the things concerning Jesus, though he knew only the baptism of John. He began to speak boldly in the synagogue, but when Priscilla and Aquila heard him, they took him aside and explained to him the way of God more accurately. And when he wished to cross to Achaia, the brothers encouraged him and wrote to the disciples to welcome him. When he arrived, he greatly helped those who through grace had believed, for he powerfully refuted the Jews in public, showing by the scriptures that the Christ was Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, God is King of all the earth. Kindly listen to the tune.
God is King of all the earth. God is King of all the earth. All peoples clap your hands. Cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord the Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth. God is King of all the earth. God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skill. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. God is King of all the earth. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. I come from the Father and have come into the world, and now I'm leaving the world and going to the Father. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, truly, truly, I say to you, whatever you ask of the Father in my name, he will give it to you. Until now, you have asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. I have said these things to you in figures of speech. The hour is coming when I will no longer speak to you in figures of speech, but will tell you plainly about the Father. In that day, you will ask in my name. And I do not say to you that I will ask the Father on your behalf. For the Father himself loves you, because you have loved me and have believed that I come from God. I came from the Father and have come into the world, and now I am leaving the world and going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once again in our Gospel today, we find the intimate relationship that Jesus has with God the Father. God has sent him into the world and he goes back to the Father. But what is interesting is that in this intimacy, he shares with us the beautiful fact that we too are loved by God. And for this, we must believe in Jesus. We must be ready to accept him as our Savior and our Lord. And he says that whenever we ask God and pray to God, we must ask for things in his name. Let us believe, brothers and sisters, in this fact, that just as God has loved his son Jesus, he loves all of us as well. And we must share this love as best as we can. Amen.
United in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O Lord. We are the wheat of Christ. If we be ground in the middle of life, may we found your name, united in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O Lord.
Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of the spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Then we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Praise you, Lord, for the blessings you shower on us. We thank you for your Son, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe and healthy. And as we surrender our fears and anxieties into your hands, We pray that you may guard us and protect us and keep us safe. Lord, we pray for healing in our world. We lift up to you the many people who are struggling. We lift up to you those who have important decisions to make. We pray for relationships, especially those that are estranged. Lord, we know that when we cooperate with you, wonderful things can happen in this world. And we seek your strength and your healing in all our lives. Bless every effort of ours to bring peace and joy in the world. And as we reach out in love to those who are struggling and suffering, may we bring them Jesus in everything that we say and do. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace and celebrate the gospel with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
To follow the Lord and find freedom, to love as He loved and bring peace, to spend all our life for His kingdom, to want it to grow and increase, to search for the truth never ceasing, to look for the star in the night, to knock at the door never tiring, to wait eagerly for His light, to follow the Lord and find freedom, to love as He loved and bring peace, to spend all our life for His kingdom, to